Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
Feeling connected to spiritual ideas opens a new door in your life, new dimension of your life. You can explore many more things. Some more dimensions are available to you. It's like having a TV just with 2 channels or 200 channels. Atheists will have only 2 channels. How long will you be watching that same 2 channels? Naturally, you will feel depressed. You will feel bored. With 200 channels, you have choice, variety. You can continuously explore many different things, many different energies, experiences. Life is a constant excitement. Life is a constant excitement if you are awakened to the spiritual truths and ideas, feeling connected to the spiritual truths and ideas. Patanjali says, starts with this idea of faith and effort and time. First, I wanted you to understand this word faith. You will have faith in something. It is better to have on spiritual truths than anything else, because spiritual truths are delivered from complete consciousness. Please understand, the spiritual seers, person like Patanjali, he sees your being thoroughly, out and out. He himself has solved all his problems. He himself has achieved fulfillment. He is complete. He is Purna. See, from complete being, fulfilled being, anything comes out will be always leading you to that fulfillment. From fulfillment, only fulfillment can come. After 40 years of research and development, Sigmund Freud says, man as such cannot be healed. He says, man is sick. That is his first law. Man as such cannot be healed. Second law. For that, you don't need to do 40 years of research and development. Unfortunately, this guy did not have a specimen of Buddha or enlightened masters. That is why he has to come to the conclusion, man as such cannot be healed. But if you read the Upanishad, man as such is a fulfilled being. That's the first statement. By his very nature, he can be elevated to super consciousness. Your brain is hardwired for enlightenment. I wanted you to know an incident, an important incident. Unfortunately, great thing which could have happened to Western psychology did not happen. This Sigmund Freud's disciple, Jung, he understood, he is a seeker. He understood something is wrong with Freud's idea that man as such cannot be healed. He understood. So he realizes, if I meet an enlightened person and study his consciousness, I may be able to have more clear and deeper answers. So he decides to meet an enlightened person. That time the Ramana Maharshi was alive in Arunachala. It's a great enlightened master, Avatara Purusha. He was alive in Arunachala. So he heard about him and he decides to meet. He reaches Chennai. From Chennai, hardly 3-4 hours drive. And he reaches Chennai. Next day morning, he starts to Tiruvannamalai. On the way, after 1 hour drive, he writes in his memoirs. I read not directly his memoirs, some versions of the story. He writes, I got frightened. If I meet Ramana Maharshi, all the ideas on which we built the theory, the Western psychology, the whole thing may be shaken. The whole thing may tumble down. So I myself ready, I am open for the research, for further input, but I cannot shake the vested interests of many people. The building is now too tall. You cannot alter the base. You cannot alter the foundation. Now it is impossible to remove few bricks from the foundation and add concrete. No.
Modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis I have created a 1 year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya Yoga practices to create healthy body, spiritual discourses to develop mental health, meditations that help balance emotions, kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering, opportunity to express leadership qualities, techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
It is too tall. It's already built. So he decides on the way, turns the vehicle and comes back. He did not go and meet Ramana Maharshi. If that meeting has happened, something great would have happened to the Western psychology, the whole human consciousness. Because the Eastern masters, the masters like Patanjali, Ramana Maharshi, Ramakrishna, all of them again and again and again say, out of fulfillment, man can function. Out of fulfillment, life can express. But the Western psychology again and again emphasizes, only out of insecurity or need for something, fear or greed, man can function. Please understand, out of fear and greed, if you are functioning, after some time, your engine will become insensitive to the fuel. Same engine cannot be used. The same fuel, fear and greed, may not be useful for the engine. Out of fulfillment, if you are functioning, it will be eternal and continuously contributing. Master like Patanjali, they see the whole thing, and out of fulfillment, these ideas come out. So if you internalize these ideas and start living, you will also live fulfillment. Out of whole, the whole comes out. Even after the whole is removed from wholeness, the wholeness remains as whole. Understand? Vedic mathematics, amazing truth. Out of wholeness, wholeness is taken out. After that also wholeness remains, means out of fulfillment, anything expressed, even after expression, fulfillment will be a fulfillment, it will be continued to express, it will be continuously expressing, it will be continuously sharing, it will be continuously growing. By sharing, which does not reduce, is called tejas. In Sanskrit, for the word tejas, we have two meanings. One, fire, one, enlightenment. You see, fire, If it shares itself, it does not reduce. It only expands. That is why Ramana Maharishi says very beautifully, Arunachala, the hill is considered as a fire. Not only it represents fire, it represents enlightenment. By sharing, it only expands. Fire, by sharing, it never reduces. See, for example, water, if you share, it will reduce. The earth, if you share, it will reduce. But fire, if you share, it only increases. Tejas. He says, out of fulfillment, you can work. Out of fulfillment, if you work, you will only be expressing more and more fulfillment to you and to the people who are around you. Working out of fulfillment is what Patanjali calls Kaivalya. This sutra is all about Kaivalya. Many times, in the name of spirituality, we try to escape from the world. We try to escape from the world. We just use our laziness for spirituality. Many people come and tell me, no, no, no. Why? The great sadhus, mahatmas like Ramakrishna and all did not do anything. They were just sitting. Ramakrishna did not do anything. The whole day he was sitting on his couch and talking to people. That's what I am also doing. What is the wrong? People have their own opinions, their own ideas. Ramana Maharishi was always lying down. Why not me? Understand, the state of consciousness, that plays a major role. You cannot understand their ideas and try to imitate in your life. You cannot compare with them and try to imitate them. They were fulfilled. So even their silence was fulfilling everybody. Even in their silence, they fulfilled thousands of people. If you are doing anything out of your fulfillment, it will be fulfilling everybody, including the animals who come around you, even the animals. Stavaram Jangamam. In Sanskrit, we have two words.
क्या आप स्वयं एक अवतार पुरुष से अपने जीवन में दिव्य मार्गदर्शन चाहते हैं? प्रस्तुत करते हैं अवतार पुरुष से वार्ता।
नित्यानंदम, नित्यानंदा हियर।
परमहंस नित्यानंदा संसार को एक और अतुल्य और अनोखी भेंट दे रहे हैं।
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
अब वो live किसी के भी प्रश्नों का उत्तर स्वयं देंगे.
That's great. No, you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
8 से प्रारंभ. कुछ सौभाग्यशाली लोग जो 0800-27-27-9999 पर फोन करेंगे. वो स्वयं स्वामी जी से बात कर सकते हैं. लाइव देखें एनटीवी पर ntv.nityananda.org.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. an enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings.
Stavara means the trees, plants, all that. Jangama means even the stones. Even the stavara and jangama which comes around you are near which you go, even they will feel fulfilled. Patanjali says, work out of that fulfillment. When a master like Patanjali gives idea, he sees all dimension of your being. But when ordinary people, when they try to give ideas about your life, they have only their own vested interests. Naturally, your society will tell you work, study. Why? Because they need servants. That is the way the society gets built. And they don't care about you. They care about what they want. Each one has their own idea, what they want. They don't even look completely. Understand? Internalize the decisions internalize the ideas created by a person who knows the whole thing completely. Persons like Patanjali and all, they have a complete vision. When you internalize their ideas, feel connected to their ideas and start living, even though in the initial level it may look little difficult because you have been made to believe it is difficult. People come and tell me, Swamiji, half an hour I can't sit for meditation. I tell them, all right, sit in your couch and meditate. No, even in the couch, half an hour sitting is not possible. I tell them, for football match, how many hours you sit? For cricket, how many hours they sit? Football, how many hours they sit? No, that is different, Swamiji. See, it's like a feeling connection. If you have feeling connection, fortunately, with ideas Patanjali is expressing, you will have the same fulfillment which Patanjali is living. Unfortunately, if you feel connected to the ideas which are expressed by people who are not fulfilled, not complete by themselves, naturally you will reach only that source, that level. Understand? The person who is teaching you, constantly telling you, make money, you will have fulfillment. Have relationships, you will have fulfillment. Find your love, you will have fulfillment. Even he has not found fulfillment with that money or wealth or relationship. That's the whole fun. You are living the ideas which are preached by a person who himself did not find fulfillment through those ideas. This is what we call Maya. You are living ideas, but the person who is giving that ideas to you, himself has not found fulfillment through that ideas. Then where are we heading? In Sanskrit we have a proverb, a blind leading to the blind, both fall in the ditch. That's what is happening. See, we are swallowing the ideas of the people who don't have the complete vision with the reality, who are just floating in some fantasy, who don't even know how to think. Please understand, having thoughts does not mean you are thinking. Having thoughts is not thinking. That's one of the important click you need to understand. Only when you are fulfilled, a proper, logical, clear, stabilized thinking can happen inside you. Still then, you may be having thoughts. Suddenly they will come and visit and say hi, bye, and they will go. Why they come, what they do, why they go, you don't know. Many times, see, the kids till the age of 3, they cannot differentiate between the dream and the reality.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experience.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
They cannot differentiate between the dream and reality till the age of 3. If they feel hungry in the dream, they will be crying in the waking state. And if they feel something wild in the dream state, they will be crying in the waking state also. They will think it is a reality. Same way you also, if you are filled with fantasy, you don't know what is real and what is fantasy. Many times you can see, you take decisions without even knowing the difference between fantasy and reality. And just you make some decisions. Many times we are doing the same mistake. We don't know what is happening in the fantasy, in reality. And you mix, look inside, all your major failure decisions, all your major wrong decisions of your life would have been taken at the moment where you are not able to cope up, understand, realize the difference between fantasy and reality. That is the moment you take all the major wrong decisions. Patanjali takes us to the depth of this faith, effort, time. First thing, faith means feeling connected to spiritual ideas. Understand? If you, sometimes people come and tell me, I don't have faith, feeling connected to the spiritual ideas. You may not have the, you may not understand the utility value of it. That is why you are not feeling connected. If you understand the utility value of it in your life, naturally you are intelligent enough to turn your energy and attention to the spiritual truths. First thing, don't feel pride. If you don't feel connected to spiritual ideas, it is something seriously wrong. You are missing something. Understand, if you are not feeling connected to spiritual ideas, naturally you are feeling connected to some nonsensical ideas. So, don't be pride. That is the first thing. Second thing, you feel, no, I don't feel connected to spiritual ideas, but I wanted to feel. I am not happy about it. I wanted to feel connected to spiritual ideas. Then, understand the utility value of feeling connected to spiritual ideas. You are intelligent enough. Your energy will turn and start feeling connected. Internalize this sutra. What Patanjali wanted to say about these great ideas, this ultimate unfailing formula, then you will see, you start experiencing this faith, effort, time, all these things effortlessly. By others, this samadhi is attained through faith, energy, memory, concentration and discrimination of the real. And Sachidananda's translation. To the others, this asambrajnada samadhi could come through faith, strength, memory, contemplation or by discernment. I want to give you my own translation. I try to use usually more words to explain each concept, because the word Shraddha, you can't translate as faith. The faith word is, it can say only one dimension of Shraddha. Shraddha means faith plus the courage to stand behind the faith. That is Shraddha. Courage to live the faith. That is Shraddha. The path of the ultimate is attained by some by faith in the path, energy directed on the path, repeatedly bringing to awareness the path, concentration and discrimination. Five things: Shraddha, Virya, Smriti, Samadhi, Prajna. Five things. First, we understood Shraddha, the faith. If it is loosely translated faith, an energy to live the faith, the courage to live the faith, the feeling, pride about what you are living. The big problem happened in the Vedic civilization is somehow they lost the pride about their great tradition. They lost the pride about what their ancestors created. See, the worst thing happened to the Vedic civilization is not people from other civilizations coming and destroying their temples. It is not stealing their property. All those things we never bothered. Somnath was destroyed by Gajini Muhammad 17 times. Why? Because again and again we were building. We were not tired. And I know millions of temples have been demolished. But next generation will erect it much better than that. It will be standing again. That was not the great conspiracy. That's the right word. Done to the Vedic tradition. The greatest conspiracy is somehow we have been taught, given ideas, the way in which we started understanding and internalizing and losing the pride about our tradition, the pride about this great spiritual wealth and knowledge. When that is lost, everything is lost. Everything is lost.
Just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city, is a unique space of healing, meditation and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Biradi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974220311. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.